Okay, good morning. In morning session, we start somewhere here. Okay, is it a causal system or stable system? It's last one. H of n equals to delta of n plus 2 delta of n plus 2 plus 3 delta of n minus 7. First of all, is it a causal system? Yeah, one of you
Yes,
is not a causal system, right? Because of this fact, the second term is there, right? If my input is x of n, the output I am going to get is x of n plus 2 into x of n plus 2 plus 3 into x of n minus 7. X of n plus 2 means it's future, right? Future input. This is non-causal system. And this is a stable system. But this is a stable system. This is an FIR system, right? A stable system but non-causal. Well, let us go to 16th question. Some analog signal x of t equals to cos 2 pi f t, where f equal to 2 kilohertz. Register x of t passes through an ideal delay channel with a propagation delay of 5 milliseconds. Then what is the phase shift introduced by the channel to our signal? X of t equals to cos 2 pi f t is given to us, where f equals to 2 kilohertz. It means 2 into 10 power 3 hertz. And after passing through an ideal delay system, where delay for this one is 5 milliseconds. This corresponds to 5 milliseconds, 5 into 10 power minus 3 seconds. Then the corresponding one is replacing t with t minus tau derived by tau seconds, right? As 2 pi f into t minus tau. It means t minus 2 pi f tau, right? This corresponds to my phase pi. Pi equals to minus 2 pi f tau. That equals to minus 2 pi into 2 into 10 power 3 f, right? Into tau means pi milliseconds into 10 power minus 3. This gets cancelled out. What is 10? Minus 20 pi, right? Minus 20 pi. The odd, the even multiple of pi, right? The even multiple of pi. This is something like 2k pi, 2k pi, where k equals to minus 10. K is some integer z, right? That is nothing but zero phase only, right? If that is even multiple of pi, then the phase is nothing but zero, effectively. 2k pi is equivalent to zero because k belongs to z, right? That can be anything. Okay, if z equals to root 2 minus j root 2 is in ROC for some z transform, then which of the following is R2? We have seen something, right? Like if Z equal to Z1 in ROC is in ROC, then mod Z equals to mod Z1 also in ROC. Here it is given that some Z1 equals to root 2 plus J root 2. Root 2 plus j minus j root 2, right? Root 2 minus j root 2. This is in ROC. It implies that mod z equals to mod z1 also in ROC. Magnitude of this one is nothing but ROC, which is equals to mod z equals to mod z1 means root of root 2 whole square plus minus root 2 whole square. That's nothing but 2 plus 2. Root 4 is 2, right? Mod z equal to 2 is in ROC. This entire circle corresponds to radius 2 and center 0 comma 0 is in ROC. Mod z equal to 2 is part of ROC. It means mod z equal to 2, this entire circle with radius 2 is in radius 2 or radius root 2. What is the radius of this circle? is it 2 or root 2? Margin equals to root x square plus y square. If x and y are real part and imaginary part, root x square plus y square equals to root 2 whole square. Implies radius is root 2, right? Radius of this one is root 2. Okay, this is in R over C. And magnitude of this one also 2, right? That's why this is also in R over C. And magnitude of this one also 2. So this is also in R over C. All three are in R over C. Okay, which of the following is are true regarding the moving average system with length of impulse response 10? Yeah, this one we had discussed in our class, regular class. It will behave like a low pass filter. The spectrum we are going to get for this DDFT, after DDFT, the spectrum, if you try to plot, it's more or less similar to low pass filter, right? Low pass filter. And it is a stable system. By default, it's stable, right? Because it's a FIR system, finite impulse response system. Length of this one is 10. A stable system. It's not high pass because that is low pass, right? Okay, let x of n equals to delta of n plus 1 plus delta of n plus delta of n minus 1 plus delta of n minus 2 be the input to the LTI system with this impulse response delta of n plus delta of n minus 1. And the corresponding output sequence y of n is. Okay, I'll ask something. Input to LTI system is x of n. This is my impulse response of the LTI system, which equals to delta of n plus delta of n minus 1. This is my linear time invariant system impulse response. Then what is the output y of n? Yeah, can you answer this? What is the linear convolution of this with this?
X of n plus x of n.
Yes, x of n plus x of n minus 1. Because delta of n convolution with x of n is x of n. Delta of n minus 1 convolution with x of n is x of n minus 1. Due to linearity, you can add them. This output we are going to get. We are doing the same thing here. X of n plus x of n minus 1. X of n means delta of n plus 1 plus this one. It means this is equals to 1 for n equal to minus 1, equal to 1 for n equal to 0, equal to 1 for n equal to 1, equal to 1 for n equal to 2. Otherwise that is 0, right? Between minus 1 to 2, x of n is 1. X of n is 1 between minus 1 to 2. This is my x of n, given x of n. Now, I need to add this one with this, right? X of n minus 1. X of n minus 1 is shifting right side by 1 unit. Minus 1 will be shifted to 0. 0 will be shifted to 1, 1 will be shifted to 2, 2 will be shifted to 3, and all others are zeros. Here all others are zeros. If I add these two things, then I am going to get, before this, everyone is 0, 0 plus 0 is 0, and minus 1, 1 plus 0 is 1. And at 0, 1 plus 1 is 1, 1 plus 1 is 2, right? See 2. Minus 1, 0. At 1, 1 plus 1 is 2. And at 2, the sum is 2, right? And at index 3, 1 plus 0. That's 1. This is what I am going to get finally. And all others are zeros, right? That addition. Okay, this is a mathematical representation of that, right? Mathematically, you can represent this as delta of n plus 1 plus 2 times delta of n plus 2 times delta of n minus 1. Delta of n minus 1 plus 2 times delta of n minus 2 plus 1 times delta of n minus 3. It's a mathematical representation. Okay, which of the following is, otherwise are, there can be more options, representing accumulator system, and x of n, y of n are the input and output sequences of the accumulator system. You can see all the answers are correct in this case, accumulator system. Okay, we'll try to justify that. Accumulator system means y of n equals to sigma k equals to minus infinity to n x of k. We will try to add the input up to index n, the current index. This can also be written as, this we have seen in our class itself. Yeah, what should be true for this? Is it okay? N minus k, right? Sigma k equal to 0 to infinity x of n minus k. This is also true. And one more thing is, this is y of n. What about y of n minus y of n minus 1? Y of n minus y of n minus 1 equals to, let me consider this one. For my y of n, minus infinity to n x of k minus y of n minus 1. Replace n with n minus 1, right? Sigma k equals to minus infinity to n minus 1 x of k. Then what is this difference? Can someone answer?
X of n.
Yes, this is x of n, right? Because everything else is common. Till n minus 1, all gets cancelled out except this one. Implies y of n equals to x of n plus y of n minus 1. Let me go to y of n minus y of n minus 2. It implies sigma k equals to minus infinity to n x of k minus sigma k equals to minus infinity to n minus 2 x of k. That is nothing but up to n minus 2, everything gets cancelled out. Leftover things are n minus 1 and n.
N.
This will be x of n plus x of n minus 1. Implies y of n equals to y of n minus 2 plus x of n plus x of n minus 2. It means all three are correct here. Okay, let x of n, y of n be the input and output sequences of discrete system. Then which of the following is are representing a causal system? Which one of them is not a function of future inputs? That's what we want, right? Causal system means it should not be a function of future inputs. For example, consider this first one, y of n equal to sigma k equals to minus 10 to 0, x of n plus k. If you try to expand this one, this will be x of n minus 10 plus x of n minus 9 plus and so on, x of n. This is just a function of present and past, not function of future input. So this is a causal system. And once again, if you try to expand this one, x of n minus 2 plus x of n minus 3 plus and so on, x of n plus 10. This is also a causal system. It's not function of future inputs. And if you look into this one, this is also a causal system. If you expand it, it's not a function of future inputs. And last one is non-causal system. Because for k equal to 0, x of n, that's fine. For k equal to 1, x of n plus 1. For k equal to 10, x of n plus 10. It's a function of future inputs, right? This is non-causal system, this last one. Okay, how many bytes of memory required to store an analog switch signal of 10 seconds duration, which is sampled at a rate of 10,000 samples per second, and each sample is represented by 16 bits without any extra processing, where 1 mega sample, 1 mega is nothing but 10 power 6, Okay, let me complete this and after that, ten second speech signal sampled at 10,000 samples per second. That 10 seconds speech signal sampled at 10,000 samples per second. Samples per second, right? And each sample represented by 16 bits. 16 bits means how many bytes?
2 bytes.
2 bytes, right? You see, 2 bytes. And we need to compute how much memory we require. Total number of samples we are having is 10 seconds, each second 10,000 samples. 10 power 4 into, and each sample 16 bits. It means 2 bytes. That equals 2 into 10 power 5 bytes. That equals to 0.2 megabytes. Mega means 10 power 6. Let us consider a speech signal x of t bandwidth to 4 kHz is sampled at a rate of 40,000 samples per second, and the corresponding discrete time signal is denoted by x of n. Let us assume that ideal filters exist. Then, from which of the following signals we can reconstruct our signal x of t properly? X of t 4 kHz bandwidth, f max equals to 4 kHz and f s equals to 40, correct? It's given like maximum frequency is 4 kHz and f s equals to 40 kilo samples per second. 40 kilo samples per second. Then what about x of 2n corresponds to? Implies x of n with this sampling rate. This is nothing but equivalent to x of nts. Equivalent to x of nts. This is nothing but equivalent to x of nts, which is equals to x of n by fs, right? Ts equals to 1 by fs. Like that you can think. This is nothing but x of n by fs. Where fs equals to 40,000 samples per second. Now what about x of 2n equivalent to? X of 2n is equivalent to, see, replacing n with 2n here. 2nts. 2nts means 2n by fs. 2n by fs means 2n by fs by 2, right? Replacing this n with 2n, n with 2n, n with 2n, and I will take this 2 to divide by fs, right? Fs divided by 2, then this will come up, right? This is nothing but equivalent to sampling rate of fs by 2. Fs by 2 means 40 kilo samples per second. 20 kilo samples per second, because fs equal to 40, right? 20 kilo samples per second. Is it enough? 20 kilo samples per second. With this maximum frequency, we required sampling rate. Here, updated sampling rate is 20 kilo samples per second. We need a sampling rate of at least 8 kilo samples per second, right? Need sampling rate greater than 2 into 4k, which is 8,000 samples per second. At least this much sampling rate we require. 20 kilo samples per second is above this, right? There is no worry about this. It's valid, that's fine. And second one is x of 4n. X of 4n corresponds to which one? What is the sampling rate with this? n divided by fs by 4. Replacing n with 4n, replace this n with 4n, then this will become fs by 4. Then this will be our updated sampling rate. Fs by 4 means 10,000, right? 10 kilo samples per second, which is above 8 kilo samples per second. Still, we can reconstruct that properly. It's probably reconstruct, right? Now let's go to x of 6n. X of 6n means, what is my updated sampling rate? X of 6n means fs by 6, right? Fs by 6 means 40k divided by 6. 20k by 3 means 6.66k, which is less than 8000 samples per second. Less than that, right? The under sampling. We should have at least this much. It means we can't reconstruct with this. And one more thing left over is x of 7n implies fs by 7 equivalent sampling rate, which is less than 8 kilo samples per second. Here also we can't reconstruct that properly. That's not possible. Okay, let me modify this file.